שבוע טוב, ברשות מורי ורבותיי. חזק חזק ונתחזק ופיניש ספר בראשית וסתם ספר שמות. שיהיה בשורות טובות, הרבה הצלחה, הרבה נחת. ויהיה שבוע טוב. Today officially we are in the אוהל משה ראה מאמנה. מזל טוב, מזל טוב להכנסת ספר תורה. שהרבה שמחה בעזרת השם. ברוך אלוהים יהושע. The parasha of Vayechi is the parasha of ברכות. Blessing, blessing, blessing. And the when Yaakov started the brachot, he started with Reuven. And he said to Reuven, Reuven, you are wrong. Therefore I won't make you not the king, not the firstborn, not the Kohen. He goes out. נכנסים שמעון ולוי, he say, oh, you are tough people, cannot live with you. You are stubborn, you are angry. I'm going to spread you all over Israel.
So there's the blessing.
So then Yehudah, he saw that it's not the right mood. He was going backward to the door. Then it says, Yehudah, ata yoduch achecha. So Yaakov, he says, you are on a different list, come here. And he says, ata yoduch achecha. מה זה נקרא, ata yoduch achecha? So Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai says in the Midrash, after many years, they say, for my children, there won't be not Reuveni, not Shimoni, not Levi, but it's going to be Yehudi, named after you. This is the first blessing that he gives them. And then he says that you are like a lion and you are going to be strong. But you know, when I learned that the parasha...
Lama gul ariyeh, no ariyeh.
Huh?
Lama gul ariyeh,
okay. Ariyeh chodash laman, gul ariyeh. The real lion is very lazy. But the Gugariah is the one with the pilper, with the parrots, you know. Yehuda-san, his name was parrots, you know. In Russian, it's mean pepper. So, there is a word that appears once in all the Torah, in the blessing of Yehuda, and it attracts me because when there is it's written one, it's open to a wide interpretation. When he start to, about Yehuda, he say, you are the lion, then he start to describe the land of Yehuda. And describe how much Yehuda is going to be fruitful, his land in Israel, full of grapes and wine. So we say, Osri legefen yiro, you're going to take one donkey to take one time fruits from one of the trees of the vineyard, or the vine tree, ולסורקה בני אתונו, חיפש ביין לבושו, that's going to be, if somebody wants to make color, once we used to take color from trees, from fabric, so if somebody really wants to take red color, we'll take the from the grape, and color the such a strong color. And then he says, חכלילי עיניים יין, ולבן שיניים מחלב. חכלילי, it's written once in the Torah. And all the Mefarshim says, מה נקרא חכלילי עיניים יין? The eyes are חכלילי from wine. So, Rashi on the spot says, חכלילי, he goes from Mishlei, it's written in the Levim Tovim another time, חכלילי talks about when a person gets drunk, his eyes become red. As Chachlili, according to him, is there's so much, it's going to be so much wine, it's going to affect the redness of the eyes of the people. This is what he said. ולכן הוא אומר, Chachlili לשון אודם, something reddish, Chachlilut עיניים וכו'. ומה זה נקרא חלב, this milk? One say about the cows and over there, one say, it's interesting, that חלב mean is white wine, it's called חלב. Red wine is called yain, and white is called chalav. It's called because it's white. The Gemara in Masechet Brachot goes to a different direction. מה זה לבן שיניים מחלב? Totally different pshat. They say if somebody gave donation to somebody, he made a mitzvah. But if somebody מלבין שיניים and he smiled to other person and he make him smile, he make a better mitzvah. So nobody is going to ask you in the Shamayim, we didn't have enough money to give tzedakah, why didn't you give tzedakah? But they ask you, were you a kind person? Were you a nice person? Doesn't cost money to say somebody good morning, you look good, I like to see you, I would like to wish you all the best, you are giving it. So we say, this is the best tzedakah, it doesn't cost money. Interesting ones, the Gemara says, the halacha says, v'ulchan aruch, if somebody gives to a poor man money, he makes 7 mitzvot. If he talks to him, he makes 11 mitzvot. So one of them says, Rabbi, I found out the best way. I'm going to speak to everybody good, but I won't pay them nothing. I make 11 mitzvot and spend save money. I told him, v'ilchot brit milah katuv, mal ve'lo parah ki'ilu lo mal. If somebody makes the brit ve'lo parah, you cannot go to the grocery with a good word, say how much you like him. You have to pay for the bills. So Rashi Omer, Chachlili, from the matter of the eyes become red, Chachlili. He understand this go like this. Now, I went to the onkelos because it's once in the Torah to say what the translation, how we translate this pasuk, and he says that Yatarkom ben Yehoyad ben Bozel Omer Kacha, what handsome and what beautiful is going to be the eyes of the king of the Mashiach. Wow, now we come to the Mashiach now. His eyes are going to be like the very pure wine, shining, and he's going to look like this, and the eyes, the teeth are going to be very fat, very white, and he gave a whole description about his clothing, about the Mashiach, the king of the Mashiach. So he's shifting already the word Chachlili to Mashiach. זה מה שאומר רשי. דרך רשב"ם, go with Rashi. And the Gemara in מסכת כתובות bring totally different direction. And I will read it for you, מסכת כתובות, page 111. They say the follow. מה דתם אומרת הגמרא, what is written in the Torah, אוסרי לגפן עירו. It is going to be such a big tree with a lot of wine. Okay. And if you say just a lot of wine, but it's not so red, it's going to be, you can use it as a color, to color rugs, to color something, as a coloring thing. And if you say that it doesn't have taste, sometimes in America you buy big cucumbers and big tomatoes, but it tastes less. אומר תלמוד לומר חכלילי, חייך לילי. If somebody tasted it in the חייך, הוא אומר give me more, לילי, give me more, more. So חכלילי changing from red to give me please, I want more. חכלילי, חייך לילי. This is the גמרא עם מסכת כתובות. So one explanation I told you is the eye become red. One explanation I told you, the beauty of the Mashiach. One explanation I told you, the taste of these grapes. And we go on and on with the explanation. Now, let's go to, so this, according to this, is the nikra tasty. Now, בראשית רבה, מה זה נקרא חכלילי? This is the Sanhedrin, that most of them were the judge, the שבט of יהודה. מה זה נקרא חכלילי? From the word wisdom. And what is wine? Wine resembles the Torah. What is it teaching us for this? I open the Zohar HaKadosh, and the Zohar say, he talks about over here, the wine and the milk talk about the Torah Shebal Veh and Torah Shebal, the written and the oral Torah. And I will explain. this line go to Orachayim HaKadosh, and he says like this, there is a mitzvah to learn Torah. There is mitzvah tonight to come over here to learn with me. Now, Omer Orachayim, if somebody comes to Shiur Torah and feel bored, and it doesn't make him interested, so there are two options. Either the teacher is not good, it's your choice, but if somebody feels that he's doing a favor that he's coming to learn Torah, and he doesn't want to learn the Torah, whatever he is learning Torah goes to the evil inclination, the Sitra Achara. Meaning, one of the curses of the snake is to not to enjoy taste. Whatever the snake eats, it's like ashes. Tasteless. So one rabbi say, it's a blessing. Whatever he eats, he doesn't have to look for the all the everything is taste, you know. Because he doesn't have the taste. Whatever he doesn't have the taste, he cannot enjoy it. So we say if somebody is learning Torah and doesn't feel the enjoyment, all the energy goes to the snake. It becomes tasteless. Lachen, the Torah called the wine and the Torah called milk. And they have great taste. So if somebody really wants to check himself when he's learning something, learning Daf HaYomi, learning Shur Torah, listening to something, if he doesn't feel enjoyment, something is missing in his Yirat Shamayim, according to this explanation. He's missing something. But he's learning. He's doing you a favor, doing himself a favor. He wants a better place in Gan Eden. He wants the front row in heaven. This is already politics. When people learn Torah, the idea is to come to a point that they are like wine can make you drunk. The Torah can make you so involved that you forget everything. Then you become connected to the Torah. Lachen Chachlili mean not just to get drunk. Chachlili mean to a person to know to appreciate that every word of Torah that we're learning, we are creating another world and another world. And if you feel a certain excitement, you're in. You can learn, you can see it, you can do whatever you want, but if you don't feel connected, it's a problem. Today, before I came to the shiur, I met a young couple. They're married for 10 years, and they have a big problem. So I tell them, so tell me what's the problem. So the wife says, Rabbi, I cannot complain about my husband. He works very hard. He pays all the bills. But I'm not married. If he comes home, he's on the phone. He comes home at 11, 12 o'clock at night, I cannot say nothing. His friend calling him, he goes. The house, nothing is missing. But I'm not married for 10 years. What is his reaction? Look at her, she doesn't appreciate, she doesn't say. I say, she didn't say she doesn't appreciate. She says she doesn't have a partner. And for 2 hours, therefore I came late, I tried to explain him that she needs him. Whenever she asks something, he says, okay, take $100, take $500, take $100, but don't talk to me. And it kills her. So I tried to explain after 10 years that the wife means talk to her, responsibility. What he's telling me is the result, is that how he acts. Doesn't matter what I do, she's never happy. Therefore, he's not committed to make her happy. I say, this 1 + 1 is 200, not 2. You sign the ketubah to make your wife happy. If she's not happy, it's her problem. You have to make her happy. She has to feel you that you are there. You say, no, I do my best, I work very hard. I walk like a donkey. But after the donkey, you stay a donkey. After the walk, you stay a donkey. Meaning, that if somebody can learn Torah, be religious, can come to Shiurei Torah, can put Shiurei Torah, but he doesn't feel that the Torah give him a certain energy, he's not connected. Why? Because he thinks about more important things. If he's going to see a basketball game, he's going to feel more connected. If he's going to see baseball or whatever he likes, this is going to see, you know, there is, who is against you and what happened, whatever, and it's a home run and it's that. So, Chachlili and I, according to the Or HaChaim and the Zohar HaKadosh, is that Hashem gave a blessing to Yehuda that his Torah is going to be listened, and if they're going to learn Torah, they're going to shine from the Torah. This is beautiful. And then we have over here the Ramban. The Ramban on the parasha, the Nachmanides, he says something, I'm going to read it because it's extremely important, and you will say, it's 800 years ago, therapy of the Rambam to all of us in our world. מה זה חכלילי עיניים? He said, what does mean this word חכלילי עיניים? So he said, most of the interpreter explained that the eyes became red from over-drinking. שהתמיינו עיניו מרוב שתיית יין. As they say it in Mishlei. And I think it is the opposite explanation. What's the opposite? In Hebrew, the word kachol talks about, in a modern Hebrew, is blue. נכון? נשמיים כחולים, תחלת כחול. But בעברית, לכחול is to put makeup on the eyes. מכחול, the brush that makes the makeup, it's called מכחול, ולכחול is to put makeup. And he says, in Arabic, al-kahal, he says too. And then he says, then explain like this. Can something with those who use all kind of powder to whitening their teeth and to fix their eyes, v'amashal, of course, the pshat is there's going to be a lot of wine in the land of Yehuda, but, he says, it means over here, to put something on the eyes that people are going to hide him being drunk. Today, simple, somebody put in the middle of the day, the winter midnight, to go with black eyeglasses, it means in most of the cases that is drug issues. So it's like a camouflage of hiding addiction. או יאמר שעיניו כחולות ביין ולא יוכל להסתיר שכרותו. He tried to hide it and he cannot because his eyes are red and he's embarrassed. או יאמר חכלילות עיניים שיצטרך לכחול עיניו תמיד למאחרים על היין. To those who are drink every night and get addicted, they get drunk every night, כי היין יחשיך את עיניהם. The wine is going to make them feel not good and they're going to spend so much time about it. ויורידו דמעה ותמלק בחורן, and the eyes are going to become very not nice, and they are going to use all the time the makeup to look that everything is okay. אומר כאן, יספר הכתוב בגנות היין. He talks about the how bad is the habit of addiction. בהרעות שבאות אליו הם בחוץ, מדנים מבפנים, ושישמע בביתו, אוי ואבוי, זה say, don't get addicted, he says, 800 years ago, the Nachmanides. ויזכיר הנזק, וזה פירוש העניין ונכון. I want to ask you a question, I with all the respect to the Nachmanides. There is a blessing here. Yaakov is blessing Yehuda. How can you put in the word of blessing, it's overdrunk, it's addiction, he has to put makeup, he has to put eyeglasses, he has to hide himself. What is the
point?
As Boris Menasela Asbir is very simple, that it goes to both directions. And with your permission, I'm going to follow your direction. I was thinking yesterday night, Chachlili is a very rare word, once in the Torah. So I was checking the accounting of Chachlili, and it came to 108. Yes. In Russia, there was Tatya, Stova Smoy, about all kinds of people, all kinds of addictions problem. So, but 108 is the gematria of the word Gehenom. And the question is like this. Why we put Chachlili in the blessing of Yehuda? And over here I want to teach you something that unfortunately in America we have to go through this. Yaakov is telling to Yehuda, my son, you're going to get so much blessing. The money is going to fly from the ceiling down. There's going to be so much wine, so much this. You know, he talks about over here a kind of a miracle, inside of a miracle, and of a miracle. Omer the Nachman is Yaakov tells Yehuda, my son, it's not a blessing, it's a test. How many people did you know that became rich and didn't lose themselves? Maaser. What's the problem? Hashem gave him. Hashem gave. He gave him all the blessing, his gefanim and this and everything. But over here, the Omer Ramban, the problem starts. When you have extra blessing, the majority of us are going to use it against themselves. Somebody once told me, a woman, she called me, Rabbi, I live in a golden cage. So she's in a cage, so she's a prisoner in this cage. Or when the man starts to feel that because he has money, he's become paranoid and he does be organ. And many, many good people that I know that they came to America and they became very rich, they lost it. It wasn't a blessing for them. So when I spoke at the Brei Torah in the morning with the Rabbanit, God bless her, she says, you know what, maybe the generation who became rich can understand it, but their children will have problems definitely. Because they don't know how to accept it. It's very easy. And easy come, easy go, and it's very true. How to maintain second, third generation? So Yaakov is telling to Yehuda, I give you a blessing. Omer Nachman Ladiz, it's a very dangerous blessing. You give him a blessing, if he doesn't know how to handle it, it's very, very difficult. Why? Because they have access to power, which you don't know what to do with this. And unfortunately, Omer Ramban, most of them are going to use makeup and cover up when they... Today when Shabbat is over, Shabbat was...
What's the secret? How do you handle it?
What?
What's the secret? How do you handle the richness of the blessing?
The easiest way and the most hardest way to feel it is not yours.
And the second generation, the kids who...
What? It has to be a combination of a lot of Yirat Shamayim and good qualities of the parents to maintain normal. Because the kid is born without no challenges in life. And when they become older and older, they just become worse and worse. Then all the addictions start, this start, because there's nothing to do. How to make the challenge, how to challenge them, it's a big nisayon. The Nachmanides said it's not a blessing. It's a very careful blessing, because you're talking about access to power, people don't know how to observe, what to do with this. After Shabbat was over, I get phone call from upstate. Unfortunately, there is a place over there, facilities, with a few of our members over there, correction facilities. So one of them, he called me that he says that he comes from a very rich family, and unfortunately, he became addicted to drugs, And then he needed to money, and he made all kind of fraud. And now he's in prison for 5 years. He's coming out next week, and he wants to come to say, Rabbi, I want to do tshuva. I want to chozer b'tshuva. But many years ago, he was 1 year in the yeshiva, and now he wants to come back. He wants me to teach him how to put filling. He wants to do tshuva. I told him to myself, such a waste. 30 years old, such an intelligent, bright boy, born to a society which was not lacking nothing and lost everything. So, Chachlili Inayim, according to the Ramban, is the blessing that God is giving us, and not to get crazy. Yes, sir.
It's very interesting that he gives this blessing to one of the kings. There are two kings, Yosef and Yehuda. Yosef went through this test, and yet this blessing, this difficult blessing, goes to Yehuda. I'm wondering why. Why is this blessing going to Yehuda and not Yosef? Because Yosef been through all this, and he survived this test.
After Yehuda was born,
okay,
and they named him Pam Odet Hashem, the prophecy was that Leah, she will run the Mashiach line.
Okay.
So now you cannot, a prophet cannot change the prophecy. He can just enhance it.
Okay.
The decision was that Yehuda is going to be the ultimate one. Yosef will be all the time the one who is the wedding planner, you know, he makes the plans and everything, and then Yehuda is to come. Basically, it goes according to the Kabbalah to three people, Levi, Yosef, and Yehuda. It goes between three of them. Therefore, the Maimonides say, the Nachmanides, that when the Hashmonaim won Beit HaMikdash, they had to bring to be Yehuda king, and they say, we are going to be the king. And this was the failure of the Hashmonaim in the second generation, third generation. But after was appointed Yehuda as the ultimate Mashiach, Yaakov, in his blessing, he tried to enhance and emphasize the right direction. So he's telling to Yosef, you are the leader, but it's going to be in the history, it's going to change, and he is going to run the show. And Yosef, as a good son, accepted all the time. We have the issue, we have the problem. Yosef knew what it meant to be a king, he said, no, I give him all the blessing, good luck.
I don't have the headaches.
אז אומר, זה, so according to the Ramban, the word Chachlili mean the makeup in order the people they not to know how to deal with the blessing, and this cover up is very dangerous because it's not real. Oh Hashem, you have a very good psychology, God bless him, but when people come to me dealing with addiction, what is the first law of addiction?
I'm not addicted.
I'm not addicted. I can quit whenever I want.
That makeup.
Very difficult makeup. If I want, I can quit today. I don't want, but I can quit today. You don't know how powerful is a small cigarette to people that this is a small one, you know, whatever they're using. It's extremely... It's extremely. About 2 weeks ago, interesting, I'll ask you this question. I had two people kind of with the same problem, one addicted to gambling and one to drugs. And they were waiting to speak to me, so outside I heard them talking. Who is worse? What is worse? Gambling or drugs? One of the gambling say, you know, why mine is worse? I say, why? Because in the hotel when you go, they put lockers on the window because many of us used to jump to check how tall is the tower after they lost all their money. And they say, what are you talking about? Mine is more difficult. The chat was nice 10-minute discussion. Which addiction is? I told them the good thing is I told them the good thing is that you talk about it because the first law of addiction, I'm not addicted, it's your imagination. What do you want from me? and it's very sad. So the Ramban says Chachlili mean, it's mean all this cover up, which are very very dangerous. I saw in the Midrash, Rabbeinu Bachye, he writes a whole explanation, and he says the following. The Midrash says that Yehuda is number 7. Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Reuven, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda. They come to number 7. Okay? In all the blessing of Yehuda, the letter Zayin, the seventh letter, doesn't exist. So we say, why? Because he is number 7, he doesn't exist. And number 2, because the Mashiach is going to be so smart to lead the world without ammunition, without war. And then he says about, if you talk about the 7 resembles Shabbat. So all this blessing, it talks about Shabbat. As ma umer, maze umer, chachlili enayim yayin. There is, the Gemara says, if somebody is going too wild and somebody doesn't wear well, he might lose the good energy of his eyesight. But when he say Kiddush on Erev Shabbat, 1/50 of this can come back when you look at the wine and look at the candles on Friday night. If somebody wants to get the eyes of the Kedusha back to himself, if he saw something which is not good or not kosher, he look at the wine and at the candles when time of Kiddush, and he gets a certain energy back. This Rabbeinu Bechayei went to this Likra Orot, Talalim Shel Orot. Why it's so important to learn about Yehuda? Because Yehuda, blessing of Yehuda, talks about our generation, talks about the generation of the Mashiach. The weakest point of our generation today is where the people are confused. Today we are blessed with so much information that contradict each other. I'm going to let you, if you want, 50 doctors talk about this vaccine. 25 says saving life, 25 says life-threatening. So you want to know what is the truth. You hear 50 opinions. Afterwards, one thing for sure, you're totally messed up. So what to do? On Friday, somebody sent me a text. Rabbi Yeshua, you know they told us for many years that the brown sugar is better than the white sugar. No, now I found it's wrong. Now the white is better than the brown. I told him, who is sponsoring this? Which company sponsored this research? The confusion is overwhelming. And and when the Gemara want to describe our generation, describe it the generation of the dog. Pnei ador kepnei hakelev. This is a generation of the Mashiach. The dog, Baruch Hashem, in our world, in our time, is very promoted. There are many dogs that are much richer than all of us together when the owner brought them a lot of Yerusha for the children. And there are even few reformed people, they make bark mitzvah, they say. You know, bark mitzvah, bark, they say. All kind of innovation that they are doing, Rahman al Islam. And the beauty of the dog that is running before the boss and he comes back. He comes, so he doesn't stay in one place. And this is when the Chachamim want to describe our generation, they call it Pnei Ador kepnei Hakelev. It go even, those of you who know a bit Kabbalah, it go even deeper than this about relationship, about understanding how this is something which is much deeper. But on the surface, the behavior of our generation is to chutzpah. We complain the family structure is so weak. The educational system, this, the rabbi, the children, the family, the father, mother, all the system is under big pressure. So, and the Gemara says, what a person should do in order to stay normal in our generation? We have just two things. We have not to disconnect ourselves from the Torah for a minute, number one. And number two, to do all the time chesed. These two ingredients are very important. Your house, the kids should know all the time, our parents are dealing with chesed. Visiting the poor people, the sick people, helping, supporting, spiritual, mental, all kind of support. And not to let the Torah one way, because even if you, sometimes it can happen, if you learn Torah with the wrong source, it's even a problem too. A couple came to me about 2 months ago for counseling, and the woman, they became very religious, but the woman cannot sleep at night. I said, why not sleeping at night? She said, Rabbi, I'm afraid I might go to Gehenom. I said, why are you afraid so much? No, you know, the rabbi that make them religious, there is a book that that talks, Rashid Chochma talks about the structure of Gehenom. And he spent 10 classes of his precious time to explain them all the gates of Gehenom, and all this and Gehenom, and all this, and all this, and she felt so close to this. So she cannot sleep at night. So I say, why are you afraid? I say, Rabbi, you're not afraid? I say, no, why are you not afraid? I don't intend to go, why should I be afraid? I intend to go to Gan Eden, I want to see how Gan Eden looks like. Why should I go? I don't explore, no Africa, no this, no that. I'm going to explore it. But she took it so much, this, then when I spoke to the rabbi, he said, Rabbi, if I don't let them be afraid, they're not progressing. I say, but fear is a very limited power at a certain time, it's backfire. And she got all kind of, she had all kind of anxiety attacks, stopped reading, thinking about what's something wrong, and every small thing become a big problem. So Baruch Hashem, now she's, I changed her the direction from Gehenom to Gan Eden. She's much better now, Baruch Hashem. And so in this confusion, we have to pray, I have to pray, you have to pray to get the right direction and the right knowledge, because all this diversity of opinion and everything, it's unbelievable. And I got 20 people called me with all kind of rabbi talking about this vaccine. People that they know, don't know, somebody, and the way they talk, and all the fear and the threats and everything, it's a very difficult generation to live. You have to understand, we have our rabbi, whoever your rabbi you have, this is, he'll tell us what to do, not to do, we'll continue, because if you're going to open up, you not get more clarity, you get more confusion. And more confusion. This week, one of my students, he made Sudat Odaya. His wife had to have a baby, but the baby didn't turn. So they warned her, going to be cesarean. This is it. I told her, don't worry. You are going to have a normal delivery. She called me twice. Her husband said, the rabbi says so. It's okay. So Baruch Hashem, 1 hour before the delivery, the baby turned, and Baruch Hashem was the delivery. So they met, so they called me, said, Rabbi Yeshua, we want to thank. I said, don't thank me. I want to thank you that you believed. Because my problem is those who ask me and they don't believe. Because then it doesn't work. I remember there was a very big rabbi, Admor Mirujim, one of his children was the rabbi of Stepanetz. And whoever used to give blessing, were the baby boy. But he himself didn't have children, lo aleinu. So once his wife told him, can I ask you a question? You are helping everybody. Why don't help me? So But the rabbi told her, if you're going to believe me like they believe me, you're going to have it. It's not me, it's you. So I told her, this boy, you don't thank me. Thank you, because you believed. And this is what opened the salvation in heaven. It's not, the rabbi is not a magician. But if you accept that if the rabbi gave me a blessing, it's going to be like this, then it's a different ballgame. So I told him, he made the Sudan Atari this mitzvah to you and your wife, because you have the ability to believe. In our generation, because of the influence of the dogs and the unclarity, the first thing you learn, don't believe, don't trust it. Don't trust, don't believe. And it kills every progress of any person when it comes to spirituality. We start tonight with the word Chachlili 9. The blessing Yehuda is getting from Yaakov, he said, you're going to be so much food, so much wine, you're going to be so much, your eyes are going to be so red. And the Ramban says, it's wonderful to have this blessing, but you have to be careful. To be drunk is not something good enough. You have to be alert in life. There are all kind of battles, that there, especially after the snow. When you go on the street, you have to be careful not to harm the wheels and your car. And this is what we call all these bumps that we're talking about in our generation. In our generation, the simple belief of a person was lost. Three generations ago, I all the time like to give this example, one of the biggest examples. We over here a few grandchildren, Avram Nissan of your grandfather, which was one of the biggest tzaddikim in our generation. May he rest in peace and bless all the family. And they used to tell me, Rabbi Yehoshua, my grandfather told me like thing. The walker, the rabbi is saying, from this morning, all the meat becomes meat, dairy, and no dairy become meat. What should be your reaction? Rabbi, what do you say? The rabbi says so, finished. Very simple belief. Today we don't have this level. Why did you say so? I want to be sure. Now, maybe it looks because we become more sophisticated, become knowledgeable, but the pure belief of this part of this world in Central Asia, Stalin could have them, Hitler could not have them. They stayed in this place for 25 centuries, nobody would have them. They had a simple belief. The Torah says so, it's finished. We did say so, it's finished. In the city of Chitirchi, there were two Mekubalim, and Chitirchi was a, those who know Bukhari, and the word Chitirchi means Khatar, Apasna, dangerous. There was a lot of water around, swamps and waters, and sometimes there was a threat that the water will go up and hurt the city. So it was a case like this, and the head of the city, he called to this Tumak Ovelim, I say, we trust you, you can do it. So they took the Afikoman from Lela Seder, they went next to this big water, and they prayed and threw it to the water, and then the water started to recede, to go backward. So, I don't think it was the Afikoman, it's the belief of the people, and even this governor, this Goy, that they have a blessing, because we need to believe, and this is what we need in our generation, to believe in ourselves, to believe in Hashem, and to believe what the Torah says, which promises us that soon we're going to have, as it says in the bracha, on the Onkelos talks about the Mashiach. He talks about Mazeh Nikra Umer Chachlili Naim. He says, one day from the house of Yehuda will be raised a Mashiach, and his oil will be so powerful. And people are going to listen, the nation are going to listen, and it's going to gather all Israel to the land of Israel and go live around Jerusalem. And it's going to build a temple, and all the tzaddikim is going to be in Jerusalem. And it's going to be look like, and he talks about his look and about his beauty, and he says that the Chachlili Naim, he says his eyes are going to shine, and this is going to this, and he talks about the time of the Mashiach. which can happen any day now. We have just to believe. So, B'dad Hashem, tonight is the night of Eliyahu Navi, David HaMelech Alav HaShalom. We want Mashiach now. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen. ריבי חננה בן זלמן צדקו יגדיל תורה ויאדיר.
אין גדל לגדל שמי הרבה.
אמן. אמן.
אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן. אמן